it should represent the Shard inside and out. So whilst you're coming into the building, what would you expect? There needs to be a little element of surprise, which hopefully there is, but the rest of it needs to feel strong, a slight element of corporate to it, but it's got to be creative.
Part of the REM rationale though was they wanted to create something that was a facility for other people in the building, so that is about the meetings and the conferencing and the drop-in space as well. They also, and this is something that we really bought into, was how do you get the Shard more accessible to smaller businesses that wouldn't otherwise be able to be here because they're only, REM are only letting floor by floor. So they saw us very much as a sort of the means to open up this building to a different kind of occupier, a smaller occupier. And we saw that as a really fascinating challenge to do it in this iconic building.
Part of our plan was to break the mold of what we usually do, which is the tech, media, more creative type of design and sectors. So instead of doing a brand of flexible workspace to do the office group in the Shard, we wanted to do the small offices in the Shard. So the space here needed to represent the building, and therefore the design needed to represent the target audience.
Yeah, it was important to respect the building, not jar with the building. But at the same time, you know, they had done a Cat A fit out, and we took a lot of that out to create the space that we've created.
We weren't going to design it in the same way that we've done our Borough High Street building, which is literally 200 yards away. They're both close to London Bridge Station. They're both close to the Borough Market, but they are very, very different in design. And I think the main factor in that is the architecture of the building itself.
But I do think that's a skill we have in terms of taking those buildings, understanding the nature of that building, the character of that building, and the architecture of that building, and then responding to it in the context of who we think is going to be working from there. I think we've consistently done it over the years, and I do think that is something that sets us apart from everybody else, that we really consider and think about each building and what that means for the person ultimately who's going to be working in it. We knew we had to create something very special in this building because it's a very special building. And we decided to appoint somebody who'd never done an office before. So we worked with an architect called Archer Humphreys, David Archer, who has only really to date done hotels and restaurants, but he's very well known in that industry, and he does some fabulous concepts like Chiltern Firehouse and Standard Hotel. So we were keen to get somebody who, I guess, was really truly starting with a blank canvas, who was going to come up with something very different.
Within the building here, we've created some larger offices because what we're seeing is bigger businesses are now wanting to take flexible workspace. Why would you not want flexibility?
Probably the most interesting change that we're seeing over the last few years is this element of community that people are now wanting to be a part of. There are two main benefits from being in a building of ours now. We used to think that it was just about, you know, if we built beautiful buildings in great locations, people would come to us for those two reasons, design and location, and the flexibility as well. Now, actually, what they're saying is they're coming to us and saying, well, actually, I can be part of this community, which has a work and a social benefit as well. And that's drawing a lot of people in.
So this space is no longer for startups or for temporary businesses or for project teams. This is a true business home. If you can make the space and ensure the design of the space feels like their own home and their own identity, which comes through the brand, then there's no reason why they should ever want to leave, and they will feel like they're at home.
We have an investment from our now chairman and majority shareholder, Lloyd Dorfman, who started Travelex. And that then has allowed us to accelerate the growth of this business. So we're about to hit 1 million square feet by the end of this year. We've just signed to take 10 Bloomsbury Way, which we're going to be opening next year. 133 Whitechapel High Street, we're opening in April as well.
Which is where we're going to be looking to provide a co-working cafe open to the public.
All three of us feel like we've just started this business, partly because our passion for it and love for it is as fresh as it ever was, and partly because the market is very ready for it. We keep going, we keep getting the right buildings, and that's hugely important that we don't just do a scattergun approach and try and take on as much as we can and just go for volume. It has to be quality and not quantity. So if we keep finding the right buildings, we keep going.